Good morning, dear students. Today we are going to start with first topic of our grammar, that is tenses. So, are you tensed with the word tenses? Don't be tensed, because tenses are very easy if you understand it properly. Tenses is derived from Latin word tempus. What is the meaning of tempus? Tempus means time. Tempus means time. So, tenses are used to denote time and action in a sentence. Tenses are used to denote time and action in a sentence. So what is tense? Time plus action is equal to tense. Okay. Now time and action, these are the two important elements of tenses. Two important things in tenses. So now let us talk about these two elements one by one. First we will talk about time. Time may be present, that is now, time can also be the time which is already passed, already finished, that is past time, and time can also be which is going to come, that is future. So time can be past, present or future. Present means now. Past means earlier. Future is the time which is yet to come, that is later, yet to come. Okay, so when we talk about time, we can talk about the time at present, the time which is already gone, that is past, and the time which will come, that is future. Okay, so these are the three period of time. Now let us talk about action. Now action. Action means what? Means work. Action means work. So now action also can be of different types. The work which you do or which you have done or which you will be doing, that can be of different types. So verb can be simple or it is also called as indefinite. Now what is indefinite? Indefinite means we do not know the duration of the time. We do not know the length of the time. The work which is going on or which is done or which will be done, we do not know the length of that time, of that work. How long that work will be going on or how long it took to complete that work. We have no idea about the duration. So it is called as indefinite. Then work can also be continuous. Work can also be continuous. Continuous means going on, in progress. It is also called as progressive. Means that work is going on continuously. That is
continuous verb.
So verb which you do can be perfect, perfect means what? 100%. So the verb is completed 100%, that is perfect, where everything is perfect. Okay, and next is perfect continuous. Now what is perfect continuous? Perfect means it is done 100%. Then what is continuous? It means the verb, such verb which was going on continuously for a certain period of time, and that verb completed in that particular period of time. Such verb which was going on, so continuous, for a particular time, and it completed in that time, so perfect. So it is a combination of perfect and continuous. I hope you have understood the action. So which are the two elements? Time and action. Time may be past, may be present, or may be future. Action, or the work which you do, it may be simple, continuous, perfect, or perfect continuous. So now we have learned two important elements of tenses, that is time and action. Already I have said, told you that tense means what? Time plus action. So when we add time and action together, we get our tenses. What do we get? We get our tenses. So let's see which are the different types of tenses. Now we have seen that tense is equal to time plus action. Now time was divided in three parts, that is present, past, and future, right? So let us see how we can divide the tenses based on time and action. So time, what we have studied, time, about time, time can be divided into present, past, and future. Okay, now let us talk about action or verb. Now we have seen that the verb can be simple, right? So simple or indefinite plus present. So we get our first tense, that is simple present. Then we have seen the second action, that is continuous, that is progressive. So we get present continuous. Then the verb was perfect, so present plus perfect, present perfect. Then we had perfect continuous, combination of perfect and continuous, we get perfect continuous. So present perfect continuous. So now we got the four types of tenses in present: simple present, present continuous, present perfect continuous. Similarly, based on the past time also, we have four types of action. So we can get these four types, that is simple past or indefinite. Then we get past, work was simple, simple past. Work was going on continuously, it was in progress. In the past, so past continuous. The work was completed at certain point of time in the past, so past perfect. And work was going on at some point of time in past and it completed at that time, so past perfect continuous. Similarly, in future also there are different kinds of verbs or actions. So we get simple future or future indefinite, you can say. So work which will be done in future and not know the duration of that length of the work. We don't know the length of the work, so it is indefinite. So we get simple future or future indefinite. Then next is future continuous. The work will be going on in future. It will be continuing. So future continuous. Then future perfect. The work will be completed in future. The work will be 100% completed in future. So future perfect. And the work will be going on for some time and it will be completed within that time. So it will be going on, so continuous. It will be completed, so perfect. When it will be going on and it will be completed? In future. So future perfect continuous. So in this way, based on action and time, we get about 12 tenses. Now see, we have 3 types and 4 types of actions. So 4 these are 12. So in all we have 12 tenses. I hope this is clear to you all. Let us see some examples of tenses. Children play cricket. So now here, the children, what do? They play cricket. So when they play, how long do they play? We do not know. Now play, we are talking about which time? Present time. So they play in present. So how long do they play? We do not know whether they play for 1 hour, 2 hours. We do not know. So it is indefinite. So children play cricket. This is simple present or indefinite present. We are talking about the action which is going on at present, but we do not know the duration. So it is indefinite. Okay. Next example, children played cricket. Now played in past, the verb played indicates past. So it is past tense, but when, how long? The duration length is not known, so it is indefinite. So simple or indefinite past. Children will play cricket. Will play. In future, we are talking about the future time, but here also the duration is not known, so that is indefinite future or simple future. Okay. So when we do not know duration or length of the time, we get the indefinite tense or simple tense. If we talk about the present time, then it is simple present. If we talk about past time, it is simple past. If we talk about future time, it is simple future.
Children have been playing cricket. Now,
the past. So it is past perfect continuous. Children, we have been playing cricket. So playing, that is continuing, in progress. The action is in progress and have been playing. So when the action will have been playing, so this action will means when in future, that work will be done in future, it will be going on for some time and that work will be 100% completed in future at that time. So it is future perfect continuous. Okay. So in this way we get all our 12 tenses. When we do not know the duration of time, then it is indefinite. So it may be in present, it may be in past, or it may be in future. Then the action which will be going on continuously, that is continuous tense. So that action will be going on continuously in present, or the action was going on continuously in the past, or it may be going on continuously in future. That is continuous. And perfect means the action completed 100%. The action is completed. So it may be completed in present, past or future. Then a perfect continuous means the action was in progress for some time, going on continuously for some time, and after that period of time the action completed 100%. So that is perfect continuous. Okay, 100% completed, so perfect, and going on continuously, so continuous. Okay, so maybe for 2 hours, 3 hours. So you can say children have been playing cricket for 2 hours, and after 2 hours they will stop playing cricket. The action will be completed. For 2 hours that action was continuously going on, and then after the 2 hours the action stopped. It was completed. Okay. Similarly, had been playing cricket. So in past the children had been playing for 2 hours, and after 2 hours the action was completed. Children will have been playing for 2 hours. That action will be continuous for 2 hours in the future, and within that 2 hours that action will be completed. I hope you have understood different types of tenses. Now, as I told you, action and time denotes tense. Now, action that is work, we call it as a verb. So let us know something about verb. Now, what are verbs? Verbs are action words, or they are also called as doing words, isn't it? Verbs are action words or doing words. Now these verbs are used to denote an action or an event. They are used to denote an action or event. Verbs are used to denote an action or event. Which action is going on or which event is going on. So to denote that, verbs are used. So for example, dance, sing, run, think, imagine, body. So these are physical actions. And think and imagine, we don't need to use our hands, legs, ear. We do not use our physical body for these actions. So they are called as mental actions. So actions can be physical or mental. Okay. Now verbs are further divided into main verbs and auxiliary verbs. Now main verbs, which tells us about the action, like dance, think, run, play. So these are what? Main verbs. Auxiliary verbs are also called as helping verbs. Auxiliary verbs are also called as helping verbs. They help the main verb or they give the emphasis. So they are called as auxiliary. The meaning of the word auxiliary is to give support or help. Okay. Now, auxiliary verbs can be further divided into primary auxiliaries and modal auxiliaries. So, auxiliary verbs can be further divided into primary auxiliaries and modal auxiliaries. Now, what are primary auxiliaries? So, primary auxiliaries are the verbs which help the main verb to identify the tense. Primary auxiliaries are the auxiliaries or the helping verbs which help the main verb to denote the tense of the sentence. Now these verbs can be further divided into to be verbs, to do verbs, and to have verbs. These verbs can be further divided into to be, to do, and to have. Now to be, the verbs which come under to be is, am, are, was, and were. These are all to be verbs. And to do, does, do, and did. These are to do verbs. And has, have, and had are to have verbs. Okay? To be verbs, to do verbs, and to have verbs. So to be, is, am, are, was, were. To do, does, do, and did. And to have, has, have, and had. Okay? Now modal auxiliary verbs. There are different types of modal auxiliary verbs which you are going to learn in detail in your second topic. The modal auxiliary verbs which you are going to learn in tenses, they are shall and will. There are other modal auxiliary verbs like can, could, may, might, ought to. So there are so many that we are going to learn in our next topic in detail. Okay. So I hope you have understood what are auxiliary verbs or what are helping verbs. There are two types, primary auxiliaries and modal auxiliaries. In primary we have to be verbs, to do verbs, and to have verbs. In modal auxiliaries there are many models like can, could, may, might, shall, should, will, would. auto. So that we are going to learn in detail. The models which we are going to use in tenses are shall and will. Now let us see some details about to be verbs. Now you already know which are the to be verbs. That is am, is, are, was and were. These are to be verbs. Now when do we use these verbs? Let us see. Now am is used with I. Always am is used with I, that is singular. Am is used with singular, first person pronoun. Is used with he, she and it, third person singular. Are is used with you, we and they. So you, it is second person singular as well as plural, and we and they, these are plural nouns. So are is used with singular as well as plural. Means, mostly it is used with plural. Exception is you. Are is used with plural nouns, but the exception is you, because you is singular as well as plural. Now we use am, is and are in present continuous tense. Am, is and are, these helping verbs are used in present continuous tense. So when you use am, is, are in present continuous tense, we use V1 plus ing form of verb. For example, she is dancing. I am dancing. They are dancing. So we use V1 plus ing form of verb in present continuous tense. Next verb to be verb is was. Was is used with I, he, she and it. So it is used with singular nouns. Where is used with you, we and they. That is plural, exception is you. Okay. Now was and were are used in past continuous. They talk about the things which happened in the past. So they are used in past continuous tense. Am, is, are used in present continuous tense. Was and were are used in past continuous tense. Now in past continuous tense also we use V1 plus ing form of the verb. For example, she was dancing. They were dancing. Okay. So was and were is used in past continuous and is used in present continuous tense. Okay. Now let us come to the second auxiliary verb, that is to do verbs. Now to do verbs are do, does and take. Now do is used with I, we, you and they. So do is used with both singular and plural. simple past tense. Okay, do and does is used in present simple and did is used in past simple. Do is used with I, we, you, they, and does is used with he, she, it. Means does is used with third person singular, with all the rest we use do. Now in this form, in this tense, we use V1 form of the verb. Which form of verb is used? V1. First form of verb is used in simple tense. So let us see example. I do not play cricket. Now V1 play is the verb. We have used which verb? V1 form. Which form of verb is used here? V1 form of verb. Okay. She does not play cricket. Again, your play being verb is in first form. Okay. They did not play cricket. So in present indefinite or past indefinite, we use first form of verb. Have you understood? Now let's see to have verbs. Now which are the to have verbs? Has, have, and had. Has, have, and had. These are to have verbs. Now, has is used with he, she, it. Has is used with he, she, it. That is third person singular. To be, to do, and to have. So to be formed verbs are used in continuous tense.